For more updates, click on subscribe and click on bell button for latest notifications. Hi friends, welcome to Tech ARK IT YouTube channel. My name is Ravi. In this video session, we are going to see about 25 commonly used Linux commands. So most of the Linux administrators, they use these commands every day, almost every day. So these are the most commonly used commands. So you have to know if you want to become a Linux administrator, if you want to use a Linux. So these are the commands. So I already made the command videos actually. So on the playlist I have added, also you can go to playlist and go to here on this playlist and click on this playlist so that I can see that almost every command I have added each command video over here. Like each command I have made one video for that, so you can simply if you want a detailed explanation on each command, you can go on that each video and you can see that. But still I'm going to make one more video for you and saying that like top 25 commands which are used commonly on the day-to-day life of Linux administrator. So I'm just connecting to the server, Linux server, which is RHCSA7 or the CentOS 7. Now, so what is the first command is to be? So the first command is date. So the date is the command which will show you your current system date and time and time zone which you are currently in and year, everything. Okay, which means that the entire date with the time zone details the date command will provide you. So if you want to customize your date output, you can also use date followed by the plus sign and percentage options. So options, there are so many, from A to Z options. So based on the which option you want. So example, say I want only full date, so I can simply say I want only that date. So you can simply type plus percentile and the option. So example, say date plus percentile capital D and followed by the you can use any divider over here, in the sense like colon, semicolon or hyphen or slash. Okay, anything you can use as a date separator or the delimiter. Okay, percentage M, I'm just using hyphen over here. Okay, percentage capital Y. So this is the date just I'm using over here. Maybe if I remove this day over here, so the date would come like this. Okay, so you may also use maybe a small d over here. So date, month and year, something like that. If you want to customize your date output, you can also use customized output. So this date command can be also passed to the any of the folder names, file names, like that. If you want to create some file name with the date, example, say touch, I would like to create a file with today's date. You can use the reverse quotations and say this command can go over here. So what happens, the file is going to be appended with this date, so that the file name is going to be created with file hyphen the date. Okay, you can see over here like this. So if you want to create something like that every day, you want to create one folder or one file, or if you want to do every 1 minute one file, something like that. So if you use this with method, so there is no conflict on the file names, so the file names would be using the date so that is the first command. The second command is to be an attach. So the touch is used to create a empty files. You can use file 1, file 2, file 3, something like this. Any a number of files you can create using the touch, something like this. Okay, you can create one file or you can also create multiple files at the same time. If you want to create the same files with the appending with the 1 to 100, so you don't need to type 1 to 100. You can also use a different method to do that, so which is called a wildcard characters. Okay, example, say that I'm creating a text file which is starting from 1 to 100, okay, dot txt files. What I'm saying here is that create the files from text 1, text 2, text 3, something like that, from 1 to 100. Okay, see this. So there are 100 files has been created within a single command. Okay, like this you can create a files, you can see the dates, or you can also see the file content inside the file, okay, using this cat. So inside the file there is no content. If you want to add some content, you can also use the cat redirection and the provide the file name and type something like this. This is the first file created using cat command, okay, and press Ctrl C over here, okay, so that the file content is appended to the file. You can also see the cat space file name, so that the file content will be viewed over here. If you want to append that the file content with the another line, you can also use double redirection marks and say file name and say this is the second line in this file and this is the fourth line in this file, something like this, and Control C. Now you can go to the file, you can see that four lines, one is an empty line and three are the lines. If you want to add some line numbers to the file using the cat, you can also use cat -n provide the file name so that it will add the line numbers, how many lines that file has. It does not modify the file actually, but it just display you the how many numbers that file has. If you want to example, say if you want to remove the whatever the spaces are the empty lines, I don't want to add any line numbers to that, you can use cat -b, so that which will add only the content lines numbers, so which are empty it will just leave like this. So there are actually four lines, one is empty, so that's why the empty one is not added to any line number, the three are added. The cat can be used something like this. So create the, you can also use the is to create the file, only single file at the same time, and you can also use the cat command to see the content of the file. One more command is that copy. Cp is on a copy command. So copy, how it is working, instance copy, you just provide the source and the destination, okay. So what happens here is that the file can be copied from source to destination, like that you can use. Example, say I'm just using that here, just I want to copy the file, the file name, I wanted to copy to the destination called downloads, okay. You can go to the downloads and see that there is a file, and see that the file has the same content over here. Like that you can copy the file from anywhere to anywhere. You can also use something like copy, I want to copy all the text files from here to downloads, okay. You can simply use *.txt, which means the star is a name, wildcard character which can be replaced with all the characters which are before the dot there, okay. And you can simply go to the downloads now and see the 100 files are copied to the destination, okay. Here we are using the copy command, but if you can see that one of the file, example ltr file, and see that, and again see ls-ltr/download location, right, downloads location file name. So what is the difference over here? So you can see that the file and the permissions are completely different from here to here. So the file properties here, it is that June 30 and 1309, but here June 30 and 11. So if you want to prevent or preserve the changing of these files, its properties or the permissions, everything, you can use simply cp-pv. So p is to preserve your file properties as it is. Now you can copy this file to downloads, and now compare your this file and that file. Okay, so the file content and its properties are as it is. You can see that, see this and see this, like that. If you want to preserve the file properties, you can use hyphen p is the option to preserve the file properties. Copy, you can also copy the directories, but if you want to copy the directories, you have to use hyphen r, which can copy your directory, total directory, from one location to another location. So you can simply go to, now desktop directory has been copied to the downloads. This is about the copy command. And one more is that next command is mkdir. The mkdir command is very simple. You can use mkdir command to create the directory name. Example, say that I say dir name. So the directory name, file name, the directory has been created. If you want to create multiple parent directories inside the same directory, you can also use that, like this. Say ravi/kumar/youtube/tech/ark80, something like this. So what happens here, it is that inside the this directory, you can create multiple directories inside that, inside that, inside that, like that. Okay, this is called an a parent directory structure. You can simply go to that path and you can see, simply say pwd where you are currently. So present working directory is this path. Like that, you can create a multiple directories, okay, under the single directory using the hyphen p option along with the mkdir command. One more command, the next command is that mv. So the mv command is used to move the content from one location to another location, or rename the content, or the rename the file names or directory names inside the files or directories. Okay, now you can go over here and say move from here. If you want to move something from here to different directory or different place, you can simply use I want to move this file name from here to /home/aravi/documents. Simply you can simply go to the this file path over here and /home/aravi and documents, and see that the file has been moved. Okay, and come back to the downloads and see that the file has been moved. Okay, now you can go to ./documents. Okay, and you can move this file from this name to another name. If you want to rename it, you can simply use something like new file. So the file name from file to new file is its change. If you want to rename the directory, you can also use the mv command and directory name and the new directory name. So the directory name will be renamed from old name to new name. If you want to delete any empty directories, okay, example say directory one, okay, and if you want to delete that, you can simply use rmdir, okay, and say dir one. So the empty directory will be deleted. So the directories, if it is empty, it can be deleted using the rmdir command. If it is not empty, so the rmdir will not delete any directories which are not empty. Okay, example say rmdir, here I am using dir name. So it says the directory is not empty, it has some content in it. One more thing, next command is that rm command. So the rm command is used to remove the files or the delete the files. Okay, rm-i is the command which you can use to delete the files, okay, with the confirmation. Say delete the regular file and empty file. If you want to delete, say yes, so the file will be deleted. Now you can see that the file has been deleted from here. Like this, if you want to delete any other files without asking any confirmation over here, you can simply use rm-f, forcefully delete, do not ask any confirmation, and simply say file to. So it does not ask any confirmation, the file has been deleted from its location. If you want to delete a directory, rm-r and provide the directory name and say a. So it is a directory, cannot be deleted. Sorry, you have to type R over here. So the directory has been deleted. Like that, if you want to delete any directories, you can simply use rm-rf. So it will does not ask you any confirmation. It just delete the files and directories. File or directory, if you want to delete, simply you can say rm-rf and provide the file name. It will delete. So it permanently deleted. You cannot recover immediately. If you can use a simple method to recover it or some external software to recover it, but be careful while deleting. So do not use this practice with the wildcard star, something like that. So it will delete entire content on the current directory structure. Okay, one more command is that cd. So the cd is used to change the directory path from one location to another location. Simply say that cd and provide the directory name, so you can switch back to that directory. Current working directory can be changed from one location to any other location. If you want, you can use cd command. And if you want to come back to the previous directory, you can simply use cd-, so it will go back to the previous directory path. cd-, it goes to the home path, and cd-, it goes to the again previous path. Okay, and if you want to anywhere you are in, but if you want to go directly to your home path, you can simply use cd-, so you will just go to your home path directly without any further output or the inputs. So cd-, is directly home path. But one more thing over here, it is that always whenever you see that any directory, can see a two things over here. Okay, ls-la, and see here, so there are two things here, dot and dot dot. So what does mean by the dot and what does mean by dot dot? So always the dot represents your current directory path. If you say cd dot, you will not go anywhere else, you will be into the current path only. So if you want to go your parent directory, which means that you are currently in this directory, if you want to go to home path, so from here to jump into the your next level parent directory, so then you can simply use ../. So what happens, it went to the /home. Here also you can see that there are dot dot. If you again type cd.// it goes to the directly /. If you type again ../, it does not go anywhere, because the /, is the path where you can go until. So if you want to directly go to the two paths back, can use simply ../. So the dot dot represents its parent directory from the whatever the directory you are in. Okay, if you want to change from here, you don't want to change anywhere else, you want to be in the same directory, you can simply use cd. Okay, that is the one more command. And the 10th command is going to be a history command. The history command is useful whenever you wanted to see that how many commands you typed currently. So those are the commands you can see over here. The command length will be, you can save until by default is the 10,000. You can increase or you can decrease using the history file on your user, or history file on the global settings. That is going to come in the later classes. Don't worry about it. Now if you want to execute any numbered command, example say you wanted to execute 107 command, okay, simply type exclamatory, that command number over here, the command would be executed over here. Example say if I want to execute any command which is starting with L, so the command would be executed over here. See, that's the ls-li executed in from below to here, so the ls-li command has been executed. Like that, if you want to execute a previous command quickly, simply type exclamatory, so the previous command will be executed. Like this, you can use the history command. If you want to clear all the history, you can simply use history-c, the history will be cleared. That's it. So ls is the command to list out your files and directories within the current directory path, or you can also specify if you wanted to list the files on remote directory and something like this, you can provide that path so it will list that location files and directories. ls-l will provide you the long list, so the long list shows the file permissions, the directory permissions over here, and the owner of that and the group of that file, or the directory and the size of that file, and count, this is the count of that in the sense in this directory this many files are there, and this is the owner of that, is the group owner of that, and this is that directory size, and date which is created the file or the directory. That is the details. If you want to list only the directory details instead of file, you can simply use slash home like this directory, so it will only list that directory details. So if you want to see only the directory details, you can simply list something like this. Okay, ls-m is one more command can be show, this one would be files and directories will show separated by the comma list. If you want to export something like this, the files list, everything separated by comma, you can export using this ls-m command. And one more command is the df. So the df is the command which can be used to show your whatever the directories you are, the partitions you currently have in your machine, so it's going to be show you. Okay, and df-x will show you, sorry, df-t will show you details of your current paths with the file system. So what is the type you currently used for your slash, or currently used for your slash boot, all the details. Okay, something like this you can use df command. Okay, df-h is the human readable format which will show you the directory sizes in the GBs or the TBs, whatever it is, or the MBs, whatever the size of that directory or the partition path. One more command is that pwd, we already see that. So pwd is only very simple, that present working directory, wherever you are it will show simply the present working directory. So one more command is that more. So the more command is, you can see if you want to read some log files, you can simply use more, so that it will provide you the details of that file, something like this. See, so it will give you an option to go simply one by one, okay, by pressing the down arrow key or pressing the space bar, which will just go through single line by line. If you want to read some log files, you can simply click Q, so you can get out of that window, or you can also use cat command, something like this, and var messages, and type that output to the more, again also it will show you the same way. Okay, if you want to come back from that more, you can simply press Q, it will, you can come back from that. One more command is that who. So who is the command which is very very useful currently, who is currently logged in and how many sessions are open, all the details it will provide you. And who-d will provide you the details also. Who-r iPhone will provide you the details like which run level you are currently running your machine, and who iPhone capital H will provide you the details of who logged in, when logged in, and what is the comment details of that user. Okay, who iPhone A will show you all the details, okay, when the system has been boot and which run level you are currently in, and who is the currently logged in user from which IP address. And W also will give you the similar details, but which will elaborate that how many users are currently logged in and what is your system load and how much uptime of your system, all the details. And CPU load details also it will provide you, and how much login time the user has been. So the user is currently logged in this long duration in the system like this. So it will, sorry, when he is logged in, so that is the details is going to be provided using the W command. So one more command is that clear is the command to clear your screen. Okay, if you are at the down, if you want to clear the screen, you can simply use clear command, which will clear your screen. The next command is that PS, which is the most useful command if you want to list out your processes, what are the processes are currently running into your machine. You can simply use PS or PS-AUX will provide you with all the details. So how many processes are currently running and what are they and what is their command path and from when it is running and what is the CPU utilization it is using, what is the PID it is using, what is the memory utilization it is using, what is the virtualized memory it is using, when it is started, when, how much time duration it is still into the process list. All the details is going to be shown, like how many, what are the processes are running, how my system is utilizing. So you can simply use PS-AUX is the command, or if you can also use PS-U and provide you the username, and you can simply see that this currently user is running this many processes. Like if you can also filter by user, which user is running, what are the processes and what are the CPU utilization of that user and how much it is creating, all the stuff you can see that. Okay, one more step is that ch mode command is that changing the permissions or the changing the modes of the files or the directories. So which is useful to change your files, directories, details. Example, say I am taking the example of 44 command over here, 44 text file over here. The currently this file has read and write, read and write and read permissions. If you want to change these permissions, you can simply use chmod. Example, say I am changing the file to the 777, in the sense full permissions, you can simply say, so the file has been changed these permissions from read, write, execute, read, write, execute, read, write, execute. If you want to change again to something else, 755, you can also change it using the 755 over here, and you can simply say that file name. You can see the file user has read and write execute, and group has read on read write execute, and other has read execute. You can also use, if you want to change only the particular user or the group permissions, you can simply use chmod u place read write execute, anything you can use, or g in the sense group permissions, you can also use read write execute, something like this. Okay, first of all we are go ahead and see the what is that text44.txt file over here, and I'm changing only the group permissions over here, g place read write execute, and provide the file name over here, and see that what is the difference before and after. So before, the group has read and execute permissions, but now read write execute permissions. Like that, chmod command can be used to change the files or directory permissions. Okay, that is command. One more command is that chown command is used to changing the files or the group ownership, files or directory group ownership. Example, say I have text 50 or 45 file over here. So the currently the user has the permissions, ownership is user A and group is A, right? If you want to change the ownership of that file, you can simply use ch own and provide you the username and the group name. So I'm changing from A Ravi to root group over here. Okay, maybe operation is not permission because I do not have the rights to change. That's why I used the sudo user over here. Simply see that now, before it was A Ravi is the group name, but now root is the group name. Okay, if you want to change back again from A Ravi to A Ravi, I'm using sudo command over here and provide the file name, and now you can see that the file changed back to the A Ravi and A Ravi. Okay, if you don't want to use group owner or the username and group name, you can simply change the group name only using this chgrp and provide the group name and provide the file name. So the group only will be changed using the chgrp command. See, now the group has been changed back. Okay, again I am using chgrp command over here and again changing my file back to the A Ravi group. See this, now the user group has been, the group has been changed back to the ls-ldr command using, sorry, chgrp command. Like that you can use chgrp. So another command is that tar command. Tar in the sense star is the command which is used to zip or compress your content. Okay, so which is very very useful whenever you have less space on the disk drive, or if you want to send some file to the as a mail attachment or upload to the FTP or upload to the somewhere else, so which is very useful to zip the file and send it back or zip the file and copy somewhere else. Okay, so one thing is that before that du is the command which can be show you your directory size. So you can see that this slash etc, the slash etc size is 24 MB, but what I'm doing over here it is that I'm zipping this and creating the tar file. How much size is going to be, see, tar hyphen cvzf, I'm using zip file. Okay gunzip, and say etc backup, something like this, dot tar dot zz, and provide you the path. So what happens, the slash etc is going to be, each and every file is going to be compressed and is going to be created one tar file, created one tar file, and you can simply see that that file size 4.3 MB in size. Of course few of the files are missed on this because I do not have permissions to modify or get them into the archive or the zip. If you want to extract that, you can use xpf and provide the that zip file name. It will extract the all the content into the current directory path. So that is the one way. So one more is that if you want to copy the content from one server to another server, you can simply use scp and provide the file name and provide you the remote server IP address, example 792.168.2.140 is my server name, and I want to copy to the slash opt path. Okay, you can simply say and say yes and provide you remote, provide the remote user password which is going to be copy this content. Okay, maybe I use different username. So which is going to be copy the content to slash opt. Oops. Okay, scp and provide you the file name and provide the IP address of remote server and :// remote directory path. Okay, it says permission denied. I am using sudo command over here, and the okay, it says permission denied. That's okay. Maybe I can use different path, something like this. So like this, you can use that to copy to the remote server. Okay, in place of this IP address, you can provide you the remote server IP address and the path, so that this file can be copied to that remote server path. Okay, so one more command is that very, very useful, and one is that find command. The find command is used to find the file names. Okay, example, say I want to find out etc backup .tar.gz, where it is located. Okay, simply say find, provide the directory path and say iname, and iname in the sense ignore the case sensitive and say where it was. Okay, simply look at of that file name using the iname and provide you the file path. So it search all the directories and provide you the where it was located actually. Okay, example, say I'm providing /home. You can simply say the file is located over here. Okay, instead of that, if you want to simply locate the file name, okay, so quickly, but it should be say that before that, update database the command is to be run. So what happens is that the update command is going to be update the database and say locate, provide the file name etc backup .tar.gz. So it simply quickly find out that file name where it is. So these are the commands. Almost I explained the 26 commands in this video session. I hope this video is more useful for you in your day-to-day life. Okay, please follow this video and rewind back. If you have any questions on this video, you can simply comment on below. Okay, if you want more commands, you can also see on that playlist. So there are so many commands. Each command I have explained in detail. So do practice so that you can understand. If you have any questions, you can ask. Please do subscribe to the channel for more upcoming videos and courses. Please follow us on social networking sites. If you have any technical related questions, you can ask.